Hi friends, I'm starting off the vlog now. It is Tuesday and my mom is using the restroom in the train station right over there. We are in their car and we're gonna take the train to Seattle for Paul McCartney. It's gonna be so good. We haven't seen Paul since 2016, so not terribly long, but we saw his one-on-one tour and now we're going to see the Get Back tour. Very excited. Paul is like my mom's favorite, like was a fangirl back when she was like my age or younger, and I love him too, so we're gonna hit the train. All right, this is the fit for Sir Paulie. I like this tied up a lot more than the way I tried it on before, like tucked in. Just didn't work. The suspenders worked out fine. Hopefully they hold up. And it's cold out, so I'm gonna travel with the blazer and then I'm probably gonna sweat and I'm gonna take it off. But my lovely mommy, she's relaxing. She hemmed my pants so they don't go crazy with these little loafers, but the loafers are a little big, but we're gonna walk over carefully. And I'm happy with how it turned out with the nails and everything.
Great to try and write a song that if If you ever go back to those people in Little Rock, Arkansas, places like that, if you never go back to them, it might just give them a little bit of hope. You were only waiting for this moment to be free. Blackbird, fly. Blackbird, fly. You never say to them, I love you, man. It just wasn't like that in those days. So it'd be like, oh, yeah, so So, you know, I always wanted to say that. I know all of us in the Beatles wanted to kind of express our love for each other. Anyway, I wrote this next song after John died. If I said, I really knew you well, what would your answer be? If you were here today, ooh, here today. In fact, he gave me this one, the Gibson. I said to him, I've learned one of your songs on the ukulele, you know. Something in the way she moves attracts me like no one lover. To where you once belong. Get back, get back, get back to where you once belong. Find myself in times of trouble. One memory comes to me, speaking words of wisdom. Let it be. And in my hour of darkness, she is standing right in front of me. Words of wisdom, let it be. 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 Whisper words of wisdom, let it be. You live and die. people say?
Hi, vlog.
Hello.
Happy Wednesday. I am home from my Paul shenanigans. I'm looking rough. I'm just, you know, we're going through some of my health stuff still. But we got a Instacart order and I'm doing an elimination diet. I am gonna have a burger with a little bit of cheese because it's made with cheese, like just like chunks of it. It's not like a lot because I didn't realize that. So that sucks, but it's okay. We still don't know like what I might be allergic to, so fingers crossed that I don't have a dairy allergy, but we're just gonna try some stuff because, you know, it's not really healthy to like eat a ton of dairy anyway for anyone, so we're gonna try some new alternatives.
Show this.
You excited to try?
Yeah, I just want to put this
in. Oh yeah. So yeah, we got a lot of different things, so I'll show you some things that we got to try out. And then we have takeout coming and we're just gonna relax and then one more day until I can go to the doctor and get some answers. So just keep me in your thoughts, you know? All right, this is what I got. I'll just show you some of the things. Me and Lauren are gonna do a little like fajita taco thing. So I just got some little soft tortillas, a taco mix, and some raw shrimp. We're gonna cook those up and do kind of like shrimp style fajitas with red bell pepper and red onion. And then I also just picked up some things that looked good, like these little tofu veggie dumplings. I got more of my favorite salmon burgers, the Trident Alaska salmon burgers, and got some little butter situation here, butter lettuce. I also am going to try the Daiya mozzarella style slices. I'm not a big fan of Daiya cheese. I don't even know if that's how you say it. But this apparently is new and improved. So let's cross our fingers. I also got a block of firm tofu so I can do like a pan fry something with it. And then I got some hard boiled eggs. I want to try this So Delicious coconut milk vanilla yogurt, as well as Siggy's coconut blend of mixed berry. I've heard great things about the Bitchin' sauce, so we shall see how this is. And then the Kite Hill sour cream. I can stomach Kite Hill yogurt, but it's not my favorite, so we'll see about that. Some garlic hummus, just some carrots. This will be for lettuce cups that I'm gonna do with the tofu. And then I wanted to get more chia seeds so I can do like overnight oats and all of that good stuff. For milk, I'm trying out the Califia Farms coconut, toasted coconut, almond and coconut blend. And then for coffees, we're gonna try the Chobani plant-based caramel macchiato coffee creamer. And I also picked up just some Lesser Evil while I was traveling. We just didn't dig into that. As well as this banana nut butter, grain-free Purely Elizabeth. Purely Elizabeth is my favorite granola brand. And it's also pretty healthy for you. So yeah, that's basically what we got. Got some bread. I want to try these Earth Balance cheddar flavor squares, kind of like Cheez-Its. And then we also just needed more Listerine. And we haven't tried the Scrub Daddy or Scrub Mommy. And I saw it in people's vlogs. And Jared has wanted it for a long time, so.
We got the sponge version.
Oh, yeah. We got, like, the regular sponge version, so. We're excited to try this, but yeah, this is our haul. Basically, a lot of this stuff is staples. Oh, and then also the Hidden Valley. Apparently, they do like a dairy-free version of ranch. So we have lots of things to try. We're just gonna try this in the week, and then obviously some of these things like the shrimp and the Alaska salmon burgers will like carry over, and like, you know, other stuff. But I just wanted to like get a whole bunch of stuff that we're able to try. Hello friends, happy Thursday. I have some medical appointments today. I have my sleep doctor for my sleep apnea, and then I have dentist, just routine cleaning. So I'm gonna do that. I am pretty tired, still feeling a bit anxious, but I got my period today, so hoping that things kind of chill out for a second. Anyway, We are going to make the best of the day, get some things crossed off my list that have been overdue, and then I think Lauren is going to come over and we're going to have a little girls' night and cook our little fajita taco things. It is so cold, so I'm going to warm up and head over to my appointments, but yeah, it's going to be a low-key day. I'm just looking forward to tomorrow, getting some answers. Sorry this vlog is not very lively, but I just can't be until I feel better and my anxiety is taken care of. So that is what I am up to, and I will update you as I can. When you're having a panic attack, you go to Dylan's kitchen and you watch Lauren make a smoothie thing. She's on mute because it's like really loud, but it's fine. She's been cheering me up and we've been having some psychosis chats together. Sleep appointment went okay. Waiting for my dentist. I got here way too early. You have anything to say to the people?
An acai smoothie with an acai packet from Trader Joe's, scoop and a half of creamy peanut butter, some oat milk. This stuff has 30 less calories than the Safeway one, so.
Yes.
Make it fancier. I added some extra frozen fruit, and then I'm gonna make it a bowl today. So I'm gonna add some chia seeds and some honey, and then you can do fresh fruit, but I don't want to cut it up.
Oh, I need to do more like smoothie bowl stuff, and I like when you use avocado too.
Oh yeah, it makes it really creamy. I'm out of avocados right now, and since I'm gonna be out of town all weekend, I'm gonna just wait until Monday to go to Trader Joe's. But normally I go at the beginning of the week. I've been busy this week.
Yeah, that makes sense. Well, you'll see Lauren later. She's gonna be in person.
Sometimes I cheat with my watch because it'll tell me you didn't stand, so I shake it and sit. Today I said I'm gonna go on a little walk, so I'm just pacing back and forth for about a minute or so. Get the blood pumping, you know, get the heart rate moving.
She's living her best life.
Trying to figure out my highlights for stories and saving on Instagram. It's a whole kit and a caboodle. But I got it so I can sit down again.
Daddy's here.
Where's my camera?
So we are working away. Oh. We were celebrating our high reel view count that we've had lately. And watching some and living our best life. Hello friends, happy Friday. Today is my doctor's appointment, so I can hopefully get some answers about like a skin condition that I have been dealing with. I don't know if I will share. Really depends like how I feel. There's just like a lot of trauma links to it, and it's just a lot. And that's all I've been talking about and processing with my loved ones lately. So it's a lot. I go through periods of being like anxious about the results, and then I go through periods of being fine with the results. So, yeah, my mental health is just really not doing well. I want to just reiterate that. So apologies for the short vlog. I know nobody cares, like it's whatever and you understand, but just want to give some context as to why the vlog is shorter. I'm going to kick off today going to Tatiana and getting my nails done, pedicure and manicure. So that will be some relaxing contente. And then I am going to the doctor and Jared is going to come with me. He's just going to like sit in the car. Just so someone's there, like whatever news I get. I'm sure that it's fine. I've just neglected this for like the better part of 15 years. I've gone to some doctors before, and they thought it was something minor, but I've never like pushed back and like pursued stuff. So it could be like totally minor doable fix, or it could be something more that's like not on the surface. So anyway, we'll keep you updated. Gonna try to have a good day. Hello friends, it is later. I'm back from the doctor. I am one step closer to getting more answers. Things are looking okay. And I'm feeling a bit better. We will get more results throughout the next week. But for now, I'm living and my anxiety is kind of settling and I'm doing a lot better. So I'm going to relish in this moment. Things could rapidly change, but I'm feeling a lot better, so I wanted to update you. I think a lot of this mental and physical trigger was really created by a myriad of things, lots of stress. Triggers from other things, flashbacks to traumatic experiences, but more so, really a lot of stress, with just life, that can also create one of the issues the doctor has told me about. And I know I'm not like doing a good job explaining this. I'm just like trying to keep it vague because I don't like want to broadcast a bunch of my health shit out there. But, basically, I feel like I took on a lot with the wedding planning, and it's so fun, but it's also, you know, a big life change, even though we have been living together for a while. I got some pretty big news about a friend, and their like next life chapter. And that was kind of the night that I started like having a mental breakdown. And yeah, just like a lot of things added up to like more than just the immediate concerns that I'm having. So yeah, it's just a lot going on, but I wanted to update, come on here, say that we are on the road to recovery, and that, you know, got some answers. So I got my little Penelope here. Jared has a bit of a longer shift at work tonight. He'll be out until like 2 a.m, which is pretty typical, but yeah, just a lot going on there. So that's a lot, but it's gonna be okay and we'll get through it. I'm just gonna be hanging out here. I'm gonna lay low and just watch some TV. And I think for dinner, I bought these like veggie gyoza things. So I'm going to whip those up and it's gonna be great. For my nails, we did little daisies. So because all of this, all that to say, kind of circling back around, I think fixating on all of the changes to come is not helping my mental. And so, yeah, I decided not to do engagement nails today. It's not happening right now. Tatiana and Lauren were trying to like throw me off. It's happening within the next few weeks, but it's not happening this coming week. So for my anxiety, my mental state, we just decided to skip and just not create any more like realized factors of what's happening to come. I'm not having cold feet. I'm not like worried about anything. I just am a very hyper anxious person, and too much like stimulation can be a lot. So anyway, that is the update. I thought it's so gloomy out. It's raining as we speak. So we decided to go with cute little springy nails. So yeah, I will keep you updated on everything. Tomorrow, I have a couple errands to run for Mother's Day, since Mother's Day is Sunday. I'm going to get my mom a gift card and some cards. Me and Jared have to get cards for her, and then my dad and I are doing like brunch. We usually do like a brunch thing. So I'm gonna go to Left Bank, which is like one of our favorite pastry places, and get a bunch of pastries for the brunch. So that is what I am tasked to do, and I'm very excited, so. That is what's on my agenda. Me and Shanta are not okay. Are you fucking putting that in your story?
No, I'm funny.
Oh.
I mean, she knows I have severe cat allergies, but she doesn't know, like, how bad.
Yeah, Shanta is, like, Googling severe cat allergies. I cannot. So she, like, cuddled this fucking cat she's watching, and now her face is blowing up, and her throat is closing. We're broken. We are broken human specimens.
Oh, God. Wait. Oh, no, I washed my hands. Okay, I should be fine.
Oh, my God. This is our night. And in case anyone would like an update as to where my night went. Hello, friends. It is Saturday. And I am running some errands because tomorrow is Mother's Day. Guys, I'm doing pretty good. Last night was way better in terms of my anxiety. I just like have gone my whole life with like this certain condition, and like I've never like fully looked into like healing it or getting treatment. And of course with anxiety, like your mind goes to like worst case scenario. So that's kind of what I've been living in. Just to give like some backstory as to like why I'm so anxious. Like it's not cancer. It's not anything like life threatening. It's just like hard. to deal with, but it's okay. I did get an answer yesterday. It's just my mind needs time to like accept that that's the answer, because it's been going on for so long. It's like hard to believe. It's like such a simple answer, and I think like when you've been dealing with something for so long, it's like, really, like that's all it was? It can't be that. It's like my anxiety or like fight or flight is like wanting me to come back up to like, no, we have to go into protection mode, and it's rough. So that's kind of what I'm dealing with right now. I'm also having like digestive issues because of the antibiotics I took. I'm like pretty sure that's what it is. I'm just like not feeling myself at 100, and it's my birthday month and my engagement is coming up, and there's so many things that are like fun that I shouldn't be caring about this, and I just hope I can get back there. Maybe when like it's all said and done, I will share what it is, but it's just like too raw right now and like too traumatic. So just not really gonna talk about it for like my own mental health protection, but it's fine. We're gonna thrive. And Jared also, we just wanna chat. We wanna have a chat about life. And I just think we're both like the same person. Like he was even saying that to me. He was like, we're like the same. We just have a different personality. So we have like the same fears, the same like worries. And I think like talking to him and like working through everything will be like super helpful for me mentally. Wearing biker shorts in raining weather. So that's gonna be fun. But it'll be good for me to get out. So we're gonna go run that errand and see what we can find. All right, the goods have been secured. We got lemon macarons for my parents and a variety of other pastries. I don't wanna just like touch everything, but delicious, good stuff. All right, I picked out some gifts for my mom. So she asked for a gift card to this store called Wild Birds Unlimited. It's like her favorite like birding store. It basically has like, you know, all the things you need, like bird feeders, bird feed, just like everything you need. Stayed alive all the time. That was really timely. Anyway, wedding playlist, ignore that. But they love, it literally says fine dining for your backyard birds. Anyway, they love this place. It's like a local bird feed store, and she gets all of her stuff here. So she asked for a gift card, so I got her a gift card to that. And then because I spent money, she got a $10 credit. So basically like extra, you know. And then when I was in there, typically I just like to browse and see what's going on. And then I just like buy like a gift of some sort, like earrings or like a painting or something like that. So they have these gorgeous coasters, and it's actually, it looks like watercolor, and it's similar to my grandma's style of painting. She was an artist. So when I saw them, I was like, oh my God, this is like so Nanny Ellie, which is my mom's mom. And it might be like a nice like reminder, because Nanny Ellie also fed her birds and loved that sort of thing. So figured it would be beautiful. My mom would love them. So this is actually very similar to something that Nanny Ellie would have painted. And they're all just like beautiful. Beautiful, beautiful. Dean Krauser, fine art. And it's a guy from Oregon, which is where my grandma lived until she passed away. And there's like little birdies. Gorge. So I figured she'd really love them. The flowers and the birds are definitely in the style of like my grandma's work. So she would have a little fun with that. And then Jared and I need to get her card still. Yeah, and then I picked up pastries and we should be good to go. So I'm gonna head home and have some lunch and just try to relax for the rest of the day. Friends, happy Sunday. I had a lovely night with my parents, just kind of decompressed, shared with them all about kind of what I'm going through. It was a long night, I'm not gonna lie. But my dad made like a chilaquiles inspired dish, and we had a lovely Mother's Day brunch, and we just got to hang out and have some quality time. So that was lovely, and I feel rejuvenated. I feel better. trying to stay in a positive headspace. So that is my goal for this week. We're gonna run some labs. We're gonna get negatives. We're going to put the energy into the universe. I got up, like when I was working today at home, I spent the day there because we had like brunch, and I would do 20 minutes of work and then I would go for a little walk, like just a minute or two, and then do another 20 minutes, go for a walk. And it was really nice just to like have that like separation. I just think I'm like too sedentary, and like a lot of my health issues are like adding up to just like needing me to like get a routine together. So tomorrow I'm gonna kick off a new routine. We're gonna start by showering to wake up. I have to like wash this hair. We're going to make a smoothie. We're going to work in the office room. We're gonna be productive, and we're gonna walk around every 20 minutes. So just something I'm like wanting to start. And we're just gonna have fun. So tomorrow I have lunch with Jenny. I haven't seen her in a long time, so I'm very excited for that. I moved up my therapy appointment, so that will be good for my mental health. But I'm feeling good like going into tonight, and I'm just gonna try to like stay in this place, get back to where I was before, realize that not everything has to be planned out right now, to be figured out. I can just like calm down and like take my time with it. I think it was a lot. I loved wedding planning, but I think I kind of spiraled out of control. And I have some very, very exciting client projects on the roster that are coming up. So I'm gonna try to kind of like hone it in and focus on that before I worry myself sick. So that is my plan. I'm going to relax and chat with Lolo for a little bit. But this will be the end of the vlog. I know it was just like a little more condensed and a bit like kind of a downer, but I hope that you loved seeing Paul. I had so much fun with my mom. And yeah, more content to come. So see you next week.